Hello friend, welcome you to a new video of Let's Watercolour with Vanidas. In this series of videos, I will take you through my way of doing watercolours, and in that I will try to explain my process as much as I can. My objective is that jointly we make the watercolour painting a fun-filled and very dynamic activity. Hope you will enjoy. This is the reference that I'll be trying to make. In this scene, the main interesting area is the kind of umbrellas and some activity happening underneath the umbrella. It's a colorful, this we will make it little colorful. And then we will kind of make some vehicles here, some car, auto. And maybe here we will make some changes rather than totally filled with trees. We will try to make a small indication of this being a temple. In fact, this scene is taken from the front, in front of a temple. The temple is not covered here, but we will make an indication of a temple here and some tree foliages. The main subject being this thing being the main subject. And the rest of the things will be little vague. I will not be making it exactly like this. I will be kind of making everything very indicative. I mean, not very precise drawing, not very precise looking elements. We will modify it to suit our idea of composition. Okay, so we'll make a quick drawing. So the drawing will not take too much of time. I'm just making it a very, very quick drawing. Okay, so it is. It is very quick drawing. So at this point, in this area we will have our, around this rectangular area we will have all our interests, our all umbrellas, people, etc., etc. And at this place maybe we will make a small temple sort of thing. See, I'm just indicating. So we will make that temple structure when we paint it. So it is just to bring in some interest. So We will have a temple in entrance somewhere here. We will have a kind of temple entrance here, some one or two steps, and here we will have a car park. So the car also we will just make. It is, as I told, everything will be very indicative. I mean, we will not make any detailed drawing. We will make a very, very indicative car being parked here. Maybe we will make an auto also. I don't know if everybody knows an auto. This is kind of a public transport used in India. We'll make this. So we'll make some. This will be somewhere in a shadow area. So we will have some characters here. And some characters we will also make here, entering into the temple or walking, coming outside of the temple. So this is just, I'm indicating the position of the characters, that's it. Maybe we'll indicate some, to bring in some depth, we'll have some direction lines. Okay, now here we will have some. Kind of structure maybe here, so some indication, and we will have a lot of trees here, some tree foliages, maybe one or two coconut trees. We don't have to draw it very carefully. Okay. Now comes the main area here. We need to be a little carefully at this place. One umbrella here, maybe another umbrella at this point. There is a third umbrella here. I don't know whether I should be painting this, but there is another umbrella here, and here there are a lot of items. I mean, some flowers or fruits or whatever. So all these things are kind of shadow kind of thing, and here you'll find that two people are taking some item. All in very, very indicative. Maybe here we will have some shopkeepers here. Maybe here also some shopkeepers, some items, and then we will draw some characters. Facing the opposite side, so we'll try to make some people standing here. Maybe. Okay, this is the kind of drawing we will make. I think you can see the drawing. It's a very simple sketch. So we tried to indicate this particular area here, and we have added some temple entrance here, and some temple, and that's it. So we'll go for painting. Okay, coming to my palette. Sorry, it's dirty, but I usually don't clean it that frequently. I very frequently use the leftover colors also, because that naturally forms some of the good grays that you can directly use. Okay, so I'll use some blues, violet, burnt sienna. So here are some burns, I may not use it. Sap and olive green, sap green. Here I'll add some more cobalt blue, orange, Indian yellow, gamboge, and rose sienna. Rose sienna and all, I may not use it. This is kind of a cloudy scene, most likely. So you may not have very bright colors being used. I'll quickly wet it. I'm wetting the sky with the sky and maybe some part of the tree foliages. I am making it wet with a mop brush, and I'm using some of the leftover colors, and I'm just making some sky here. Now I'll make some tree foliages. I'm making some brownish blue. As I was telling, it won't be very precise drawing. It is just very indicative. I'm a little precise when it comes to this particular portion because we are trying to define some structure here. Similarly, when it comes to the umbrella, again, I'm a little precise. Here we are doing a little bit of negative painting, negative shape. I'm kind of slowing down when it comes to the negative painting because it should be little, the edges I want to make it little sharp because most of the other edges are not sharp. So these umbrella edges I'm making it sharp at this point. Maybe we'll make it later, we'll soften it later at some point, maybe, not sure. I'm softening it here. Making it a little damp here. Right, we'll get back here later. Now, I'll try to make some of these coconut trees while it is still wet because I don't want, I'm not looking for any sharp things in the even in the coconut tree. I'm not looking for any sharp this one. Everything is indicative, not very precise. Little bit thicker paint. Little bit of thicker paint. very indicative, not too much precise. Even this I feel is little bit more precise. I'm just sprinkling some water there to diffuse it. Try gradually bring it, make the middle ground. Here we will have to pick some temple sort of structure, so this again, I am not make it very precise. Little yellowish, maybe little violetish. Just very indicative. I'm making it very indicative. I think that's it for the temple background. Maybe we'll take out some colors. We might try to define something here. Just applying some water so that there is some kind of a structure there, some indication. That's it. I think we'll have to be a little careful about the running paint. Something here, we need to make something here. I'm planning to do is, this is going to be red color, this is going to be yellow color, so we will have some that color of shadow here. So very very reddish shadow here. These are usually, I think, some flowers and fruits, etc. So I'm just indicating some, dropping in some colors to indicate some flowers and other things. Thank you. just creating some shadow sort of thing. And now comes some yellowish. We'll change some colors later. That is just somehow merging it. I'll join this kind of a wall. I'm deliberately trying to leave some white space there. The auto should be very bright yellow. Trying to make everything in kind of shadow. Everything is in shadow. The car, the auto, back seat. Everything is in shape. Everything is, kind of diffusing. What is? I don't want them to be very much colorful. I don't want that. I want it to be very diffused, everything. Some light here maybe. Just everything very much diffused. I'm making very dark tone. Dark tone because I make these things now. scary. I don't want any of this to happen. Everything is under merging with them. Things are taking little shape. Now the main thing is the main element, the very colorful element. I'm taking deep yellow here, deep orange here. I'm taking to make a little bit of thick pigment, in fact. We'll reinstate this later. I'm just trying to indicate it now. We'll refine this later. We need a lot of some kind of refinement there. Now to be a little precise there. Little bit of shadow here. Adding little brown. Same. Deliberately leaving this place for now because I might give a dull wash here once these pieces are little dry. Now let to make some strong strokes here. some bright colors, something they are selling really. These people are looking this side, so they will have very shadowish color now. We will have to be little careful now, because they are under the shades. Again, just indicating. I don't really need good looking people here, very, very defined people here. It's all indicative. Okay, I think we are done here. Now some people are really doing their business. Really do not know what they are doing, but they are doing. Okay, there we need a character here. Who is really maybe looking this side. Here it went a little wrong, so I'm trying to make another character there. Maybe he's coming. Sometimes we'll have to dynamically decide what best just when something goes wrong. When thing doesn't work the way you intended, I think we have created some amount of drama here. We need to support this with some more details here. Just to highlight these things, we have to make this a little bit of darkish, and then I think some characters here and some finishing touches. We'll make this area a little darker so that we have some light playing around here. Sound a little kind of negative painting negative shapes, so that we define this car and auto with a little bit more clear definition. I'm not referring to the reference now, I'm kind of defining the details based on what we already have. I think we have defined enough. Now some character here. little lighter tones. Maybe somebody is saying just it is only seen partially. Some highlights of steps here. Maybe she's coming this side. It is too much. No problem. This is just all of these are just indication only. Right. And let it spread and go. These are just some finishing touches here and there. I doubt it is a little bit too dark. Just indicating some kind of flooring here, that's it. Some kind of creating interest, that's it. No, nothing really, really important things. think now this area is little, we need to fill this area. Very light, just a matter of filling this. Creating some shadows here. Shadows for this umbrella. We need some character here. I think we are pretty good to finish it now. We don't have a lot of thing to do now. If you really need, maybe you can give some details here, but I'm not a big fan of it. Just maybe just some indication, that's it. Very vague indication, that's it. I think this is the best way to stop it. Usually tend to give some white accents. It is not, you don't have to go for that, because there are always arguments that using white in watercolors, but it's up to you. I don't think it is something that we need to really avoid. Just used with caution. Don't use it excessively. I think we are good to call it as done. Right, now we are done. Our primary objective was just to capture some of this interest here, and then to support this some background. So if you remember, we have made some modification, which is perfectly fine. Yeah, I think it's quite fine. I'll now take out the tape. I think just we need to connect this some kind of a shadow or some something. It cannot be just hanging on the ground. I just connected it to the ground so that it doesn't feel that these characters are just hanging in the air. It should be hooked to the ground. Right, we are done. That's it for today. Hope you were with me throughout this video. If you have any comments, suggestions, questions, please do mention them in the comment section below. If you like my video, please click on the thumbs up and subscribe to this channel. I will strive to produce more videos with your support and motivation by addressing all your comments and suggestions, and I will also try to respond to your questions, get suggestions as frequently as possible. Hope we'll meet you in the next video, and we'll continue with the fun of painting watercolors. Thank you very much.